going? What stage are we going to 1-9? What do you think? Oh, we're going to Sweet Dreams. What a interesting pick in this matchup. Oblina, being an extremely light character, has to obviously worry a lot more about like what Powder Toastman does. But based on how Powder Toastman is, it's also really hard for Powder Toastman to sometimes get to kill, especially because Oblina can kind of cheat with like her down special stuff.
The flex right just... now is really strong, okay? For people who aren't watching this live and are watching this in hindsight on the YouTube channel, TNT is the person casting this game while they are playing this game. Both of the players are on random picks, and I'm assuming a random stage to boot, so...
No, we don't have random stage.
Well, maybe you should have, because really then you wouldn't have been punished by an up smash below platform quite like that.
So
from
true.
Toast. Man!
Anyway...
I like
Powder Toastman actually surviving that. I was really surprised about that one.
To be fair, it is Sweet Dreams. Sweet Dreams is very notorious for having that really high ceiling. It's not as high as it was in the pre-Jetty Patch era. Oh, no.
I don't think... The ceiling never got higher or lower. It's always been the same. What's actually has been changed in Sweet is specifically the respawn position.
Okay.
So you use the respawn in the actual like blast zone. And now you respawn lower.
Game go. What happened, my friend?
Oh, did something happen?
Yeah, it's you didn't check in for your set.
Oh, I didn't?
Uh-oh.
No. That ain't good. Oh, Nelly.
Yeah, now the TO has to do more work. Uh-oh.
Oh, I was commentating, so I didn't even realize that I was playing.
Yeah,
oops.
Me too.
Right, I'm gonna do a TO thing. Can my co-caster TNT Blows Up please take over while I do a TO related thing? Go for it. The stage is yours, literally, because you're on it.
Actually surviving.
TNT, uh-oh. I have a question for you.
Yeah, what up?
What's 9-3 divided by a third plus 1?
Right, you're asking a lot of questions here.
That's alright, if that's... I got another one for you. It's 21-3 plus 18 divided by 6.
You are asking a lot of questions here. I'm a programmer, not a math magician. Like, I stopped doing math and started doing equations. But not in the same way as, like, a lot of other people do. It's kind of weird. Anyway.
Game go.
Ooh.
Jump on
yes?
Smash GG again. You should be able to do your match.
Ooh. Okay.
I've asked. Oh! Well.
Yeah?
TOing aside, it appears that a Upstrong and Air was able to secure a stock, and yeah. Game one just happened so quick, I barely even saw it.
Like a cutscene character. And now she just does a bunch of really cool combos. Now, next to that, Korra actually also has this insane. What's it called? Bug, quote unquote, kind of. Where what actually was the plan was that Korra's down special would become jump cancelable, but on accident they made it their neutral special.
Okay.
So Korra just Korra can just get now an insane amount of momentum from just what's it called? Korra can get an insane amount of momentum from doing a neutral special instead of and then just trying to follow up from there. But while we've been talking about Korra, TNT Blows Up has already taken two entire stocks. It's kind of crazy. He goes off, man. Like, oh no, is he dead? Oh, he lives. Okay, cool.
Oh, I hope that everyone else is enjoying the self-casted, self-played game as much as I am. This is delightful. I love hearing about the Korra changes because, Lord knows, I am unfamiliar with them myself. What I am familiar with, though, is the kind of insane disjointed hitboxes you can get with Lincoln Loud using the juggle of his light airs, and boy howdy has TNT really been pushing that aggression using those this game so far.
Yeah, it's kind of noticeable that, I keep forgetting his name because I can't look at the overlay.
Lincoln.
Frex.
Oh, Frex.
Yeah. I don't want to say phase or top, but I'm like, no, that's not it. It's kind of noticeable that they don't have a good answer for the aggression. It's also noticeable that they don't know that they should hold the strong attack button when they're trying to do their strongs to get the stronger version of it, because there's never a downside to not doing it.
When it comes to Korra especially, you get that extra active hitbox out for the longer you hold it down for. It's kind of strange, because it's not something that every other character has, but she does have a Crispy Korra Tim's a little bit like that, but is punished for going for them.
It's a little bit more, it's not really active hitboxes, it's more, they just become stronger. Mm. So there's like no reason to not do it because the weaker ones just kind of don't do anything.
I see. Sorry, I'm just reading a TO related thing. Seeing it's the core Tims come out, appealing to the TA TO. I like that. Love to see some Tims. You think that the damage disparity might be just enough to just justify at least one extra stock in this game for the Korra? Does not connect using the short hop strong air attack, trying to catch on ledge, but perfectly blocked by TNT, and they themselves blow up as they are punished. Oh, but unfortunately, when you've taken too much damage, it's just that hard to not get punished in a play like that. And TNT takes the set 2-0.
What an amazing play from TNT blows up. I had hoped to see him go very far in this bracket.
God.